All these guys are like, wait, you're all a bunch of sissies. You see, you put the stuff up there to...
Stop. You want this camera down here?
Oh, so?
I think it's supposed to stay there. Because you keep taking it out and...
No. Mom, please.
What?
You're embarrassing yourself. You don't know what you're talking about.
You keep taking this off, putting up, taking.
That's what you're supposed to do. That's what you're
going to actually.
No. You leave it up there, and when it's cold, and then it doesn't stick. And that's I got this specifically because it's gonna go from one car to another.
Oh, okay.
It's just, it has a little thing here that puts a little extra pressure. I didn't put it on there, so it's okay.
Who am I embarrassing myself with?
It's just, when you say things, you always say them with such conviction, and then it turns out that you're not even close to being accurate.
That's kind of
embarrassing.
Well, maybe I sound like you.
Again, it's always about something, I don't know. It's weird.
Are we going to it?
No, I want to call it. What was that? Yeah, like I said, we have Marco's water bottle, or whoever's water bottle says, then you have that one, so that's two. Then we have the Powerade is three, and then I actually brought a small water bottle in the bag.
It's
four.
Okay.
We got loaded. Batting cages are open. It's not just 65, but the sun is going to be going over there. You're like really nice in the, yeah, it's been a while. No, so I had used the 2 gigabyte SD card as opposed to this one, which is a 256. We had some problems with this one before with Marco's phone. So I drove all the way down to Maywood and everything, you know, through River Grove and all that, and I came back and the card was filled up. So I'm like, cool. So I copied everything off and I tried to look at everything and nothing works. It's all corrupted. So I take the one that I think is good because and nothing else. Somebody was turning.
Oh my God, Steven, you're gonna pick your nose all the way.
No. You won't be in the boogers for that.
Gosh.
Actually, today was a really good day to do some droning, too. So, like, what I gotta do is I gotta drive over to the Forest Preserve tomorrow morning, like by noon, and then grab the drone, and then we'll fly around the Forest Preserve. You know, we'll drive in the car, and we'll bring it with us, and we'll drive it around, and we'll fly the drone around. I don't care. I said I'm going to go there at noon. Okay, I already said that. So if you want to go to my mother's house at noon, and then it's fine. But Marco and I are going to go to the Post Office Forest Preserve at noon to do the droning. And if my mother's house is 3 o'clock and somehow that gets in the way of that because it's noon and not 3 o'clock, whatever, man. What can I do, you know? What can I do? You know? Oh, so you always like to fight, you know? I don't understand you. I said noon, you got tomorrow going to your mom. Who cares? It's noon I'm talking about. I'm not talking about 3. You just say things because you want to fight. No, I just I don't understand why you want to fight all the time. Life is too short. You need to stop doing that.
All I said was, tomorrow?
I don't care. It's not germane. It's irrelevant to what I'm saying.
Okay, so why are you getting upset then?
Because you just make these pointless comments all the time. I mean, I try to find a rationale for why you say half the things you say.
I'm just reminding you. I'm not saying that you're
It doesn't matter.
Be
it doesn't matter. I said noon. Who cares? And I'm not going to my mother's anyway. I hate going. I don't like her as a person. I can't stand her. And I'm not wasting my freaking beautiful day going to her house or some stupid shit hanging around with a 90-year-old senile fool. I'm not going. So Marco and I can go to the Forest Reserve at 12. And then you guys can go to my mom's and you can get there at 3 o'clock and everybody will be happy. And going to the Forest Reserve at 12 will not encumber or, you know, diminish going to her house at 3 o'clock by any stretch of the imagination. I promise you that. Because the only time we've ever really gotten along in the past 10 or 15 years was when we saw Dean Reschke and he was able to mediate between us. Because there's so many things going on in my life and my mind and what's happened to me that you don't understand because you don't have any comprehension of it. And you probably just sit there going, what's wrong with this guy? I can't stand him. You have no idea. I don't have a career. I don't have a body. I don't have a house. I don't have my family the way it needs to be. I don't have cars. I don't have savings. I don't have a career. I don't have LinkedIn. I don't have anything. You know, I'm totally messed up and everything I've tried, I've been screwed over royally, and I trusted these doctors to fix my shoulder, and he didn't fix the subscap, and now the subscap is bad, and you're like, oh well, no big deal, just go there and see what they say, it's going to be done, and that's the way it is, and you think everything is so easy, but it's not so easy. If you're dealing with it yourself, it's not so easy. It's easy to tell somebody else, oh yeah, it's so easy, don't worry, just go see the doctor and see whatever they say, and if they say you have to have another surgery, then you have another surgery, you know, and if you're in a sling for the rest of the year, well, that's okay, no problem, everything's fine. I had it all lined up. I was going to work at Menards, and I was going to do this video stuff and everything, and, you know, try to be a man and contribute something to the house, and I'm totally stressed out about that. But you think, I don't know, until it happens to you, you don't understand what it is, and you can't comprehend it. If you can look at it through other people's perspectives and other people's lenses, and you can say, yeah, this is really bad for Steve, you know, his shoulder, he just had a second surgery, and the doctor fucked it up, and now what the hell is he supposed to do, and he, you know, he wants to train with this guy next door who's a freaking, you know, a savant in martial arts, and Steve loved martial arts, and now he can't do it because his shoulder's messed up. Don't worry about it, who cares, you know? No, but that, you got to look at it from someone else's perspective. You got to see what they're going through to understand it. You can't just look at it your own way. It's not so simple. They say, oh yeah, well, go see the doctor and see what he says. I already know what he's going to say. He's going to say, well, we need to stitch up the subscap. You want to have a surgery in 3 weeks? Okay, and I have a surgery. Then it'll be the middle of August, and I'll still be walking around in a sling. I don't want to have another surgery. I wasn't supposed to have another surgery. This surgery was supposed to fix things, and it didn't fix it because he didn't do his job. You know, and now what? Now my life is in freaking ruins. Now I can't go work at Menards. They're going to want me to pick up boxes and climb up ladders and all this stuff, and I can't do it. I can't do it. You know?
To see a counselor.
No, I need to find someone who I can talk to who can see things from my perspective and understand me.
Counselor.
No, you. Yeah, counselor. Because you obviously talking. So look up USC 287. I don't think it started yet. Well, then I was thinking about it.
Well, what do you want to know?
Uh-huh. You just type in UFC 287 space wiki, WIKI. And then you go to the page and it tells you what fights have already happened. You can kind of gauge where it's at. By the time we have enough time, I'm going to put the swap up down and do 20 minutes of cardio. Results. Results. They haven't even started yet. It's in Vegas, usually. So it's 7 o'clock, so what's Vegas right now? 6? 5?
Mm-hmm.
It's 6. I think Vegas is 6, and then California is 5. But I don't know for sure. So I'm going to go home and put this workout down after 20 minutes and start cardio. I haven't done cardio in years. See the sunset? You start looking up pretty late. Listen, you want to go back and go on top of the parking garage and take a picture of that from the parking garage? Look, look, look. Looks like heaven. Look, look, look. You can go on the parking garage and take a perfect picture of that. You sure? Okay.
It's 2 hours behind.
2 hours. It's only 5 o'clock. Talk to Mike? Did he see you?
I don't know.
He said he's been going to a Buddhist sensei in from Chicago. And he was wearing a necklace. I said, what is that? He says, Buddhist. He said, he's seeing a sensei is 86 years old, and he's telling that everything we do is wrong. Instead of breathing from up here, everything is supposed to come from here, and he's talking about the breathing and why we have all these diseases and everything. That's not right. When you're leaving, and then make sure you close the door. So I did some cardio a while ago, like a year ago, and he was lifting. I said, "Hey, I'm leaving." He said, "Okay, make sure you close the door." I said, "Yeah." He said, if you don't make sure the door's closed, you can't come again." I said, "I know." So I went outside and I made sure the door was closed. You hear that? Did you hear it?
What?
The geese.
Oh. See, when you were picking it up,
I washed my hands after I've done working out. That was, that was an hour and a half ago. Wanna go to 2 weeks? They're open till 8. Remember we walked there was a huge tree right there? You couldn't see anything, and then it's in a couple of months it just moved. Yeah, right.